Welcome to Lifestyle with Neeraj. Being assertive is a skill, and like all skills, we learn and improve through practice. Let us talk about assertiveness, learning, and the comfort zone. Each of us has a comfort zone that consists of the habits, beliefs, relationships, feelings, thoughts, and actions that to us are comfortable and familiar. While it can feel secure or reassuring to be in our comfort zone, there is actually very little learning that takes place here. The comfort zone can also get boring. We all have different zones of comfort. What is comfortable for one person may not be comfortable for someone else. People often leave their comfort zone for stimulation and excitement. People might go skydiving, go on a roller coaster, date someone very different from themselves, or see a scary movie. Some people may even pay a lot of money to make themselves uncomfortable, for example, bungee jumping, traveling to another part of the world, etc. Throughout life, we make choices about whether to stay in our comfort zone or expand our comfort zone by stepping into the discomfort zone. In our discomfort zone, we might feel uneasy, nervous, or resistant. This is okay because a lot of meaningful learning takes place on the edge of our comfort zone, where we may feel we are challenged. Our discomfort zone provides us with an opportunity to grow and learn. Then our comfort zone expands and the center becomes bigger. We are expanding, pulling in more things as we grow and learn. Often when people leave their comfort zone, they check to make sure that they are safe. For example, the bungee cord does not break, that the date is in a public place, etc. People instinctively know that safety is a different issue from discomfort. But sometimes they might forget the difference when they become uncomfortable speaking up for themselves. Finally, we go into the no-go, the alarm zone or danger zone. This is a place where we feel so scared that it's not possible to learn. This is a zone where fear and distress shut down our learning and growth. As long as it's not painful or threatening, feeling uncomfortable is not a bad thing. Speaking up or being assertive is something that takes a lot of people out of their comfort zone. It is important to encourage ourselves to do this and be willing to take risks in order to develop a useful new skill. Assertiveness is the ability to speak and act confidently. It can be taught and learned. It allows an individual to express feelings comfortably, confidently, in an open and positive manner. It's a behavior that allows us to stand up for ourselves by channeling our emotions properly to achieve conflict resolution, maintain healthy relationships without repressing our needs. Some examples of assertive behavior include saying no, refusing unreasonable requests, asking another person to behave differently, communicating your feelings, either negative or positive, clearly, expressing an opinion, and pursuing one's personal goals. Lack of assertiveness is associated with low self-esteem, anxiety, depression, suppression or minimization of one's needs, low relationship satisfaction, problematic or damaging interactions with other people, avoidance of social situations, inability to act in one's self-interest, fearing the consequences of expressing one's need, and so on. Lack of assertiveness can result in social anxiety associated with anger, aggression, and hostility. It leads to frustration if one's needs are not met. There could be a buildup of resentment against other people, resulting in explosive outbursts and finally arguments. Assertiveness is a sort of a middle path between being passive and being aggressive. Let's go over some examples of passive, assertive, and aggressive behaviors. We are passive when we give in. We are assertive when we compromise. In aggressive behavior, we take. We are passive when we try to maintain peace. Talking and listening is an assertive behavior. Talking over people shows aggression. We are passive when we allow ourselves to be bullied. In assertive behavior, we stand up for ourselves. In aggressive behavior, we bully others. When we do not say what we are thinking or keeping quiet is passivity. Expressing our point clearly and confidently is assertiveness. Aggression results in shouting or possibly violence. With passive behavior, relationships are damaged and others respect you less. Assertiveness improves relationships and other people know their place. Obviously, relationships are damaged with aggressive behavior. Passivity damages self-esteem. Assertiveness builds self-esteem and aggression damages other self-esteem. In other words, assertiveness is a middle point between passivity and aggression. Non-assertive individuals might hold some negative self-beliefs that prevent them from being assertive during specific situations. For instance, I am unlovable. I am not good enough. If I say no, I won't be liked. If I say what I want, I will be punished, or so and so is angry with me. Assertive communication can be both verbal and non-verbal. In assertive verbal communication, an individual is able to assess the current situation, express what they want and need, explicitly consider the other person's perspective, reassert their own goals, consider compromises, mutual agreements that would lead to a resolution. Assertive non-verbal communication includes adopting an upright and confident posture, a clear and calm tone of voice, use of direct eye contact, especially refusing or requesting, active listening, validating other person's feelings, summarizing what the other person has said without passing judgment. Let me give you some helpful tips for communicating assertively. Use I statements, practice saying no, keep emotions at bay, voice your opinions, use relaxed body language, be a good listener, allow yourself to get angry, be collaborative and watch your tone. Remember 3 C's when it comes to being assertive. Confidence, believe in your ability to handle a situation. Clear, make sure your message is clear and easy to understand. Controlled, deliver information in a calm and controlled manner. In other words, tell the other person how you feel as honestly as you can. The use of I messages are vital to assertive communication. It is possible to express strong feelings without increasing the conflict by using I messages. Through an I message, we can express our feelings of disappointment, anger, frustration, and needs without aggression or accusations. I messages usually begin with words like I feel, I want, I need, I said, I say. For example, the message I feel tells the other person your own feelings, why you feel this way, and what can be done to help change the situation. I messages allow you to take responsibility for your own ideas and feelings instead of blaming the other person. Let us go over a few examples of assertive communication. Say, I completely understand what you are saying, but I have to disagree. I feel frustrated when you do not show up on time. Start your sentence by saying, I feel hurt. Can you please explain the reasoning behind your decision so I can try to understand what you are doing? Don't say, you make me feel. Instead, say, I feel angry when you ignore me because it hurts my feelings. Next time, please pay more attention to what I'm saying. Being assertive by using I statement means taking responsibility for your own feelings. Say, I feel sad, I feel angry, I feel happy. When we use sentences like, you make me feel, this gives others control over your own feelings and blames others for what's going on with you. In closing, learning to communicate assertively does not guarantee you will have your needs met, but chances are that it can improve relationships with other people and build self-esteem. We can express our points confidently, clearly, and communicate how others' behaviors make us feel. Thank you for watching.